about at Christmas to know whether to be nice or naughty. If you're nice, they say Santa will come. If you're naughty, who knows? There are so many temptations. Which is why I've come up with my own invention. It's called this.
Squeaky's Nice or Naughty Mystical Crackers!
Yes, Squeaky McLean's Mystical Crackers. These crackers not only contain a cheap plastic toy, but the answer to the ultimate Christmas dilemma, whether to be naughty or nice. And here to help me road test these crackers is Britney Spears. Thank you for road testing them.
Well, thank you for having me.
Oh, it's a pleasure, it's a pleasure. Now listen, you are the perfect person in my eyes. Sometimes you probably like to be nice, sometimes you probably like to be a bit naughty.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, before we get into Mystical Crackers, tell me a little bit about Christmas. Are you looking forward to Christmas?
I am so looking forward to Christmas. Just going to my grandmother's house and eating a lot of food and riding my four-wheelers. I can't wait.
Will you be going to church Christmas?
Mm-hmm.
Good, good, good. And do you get much time off Christmas?
I'll have like 3 weeks off for Christmas.
And have you asked your mum and dad for a present?
No, I haven't. I have no idea what I'm getting. I just want to be home for Christmas. That's just being off for 3 weeks is my Christmas present.
See, I asked my dad for a bag. I said to my dad the other day, I said, I've got my eye on a bag. And he just told me to keep my eye on it because I'm not going to get my bum on it.
Oh.
Will you be buying presents for people, yeah?
Oh, yeah, today. I went shopping today.
What'd you get me?
I didn't get you anything. I'm sorry, but I got my friends, Marlon and Courtney, something. Okay. So.
Right, well anyway, enough about Christmas, because it's now time to delve into the mystical Christmas crackers. These aren't out in the shops yet, I've only just invented these, if there's anybody who wants to distribute them.
So I'm confused, there's a number. I don't understand. There's a number, yeah.
Well listen, it's all dilemmas, you see, you don't know whether to be nice or whether to be naughty.
Right.
Like, look, you've got Waiting for Santa, you've got Christmas Day telly, you've got carol singing,
okay.
You've got rubbish presents, you've got gas, remember that one.
What's rubbish mean?
Rubbish means no good.
No good?
Okay.
Well, I don't want that one.
Okay, what do you want?
Christmas Day telephone?
Like? Telly, it's television.
Oh, this!
Okay, inside here is a dilemma. Mm-hmm. Will you be nice or will you be naughty? Here we go. The family's round at Christmas Day. You're watching the TV. Granny wants to watch The Sound of Music. Grands. But there's a Bond film on the other side. Would you be nice and hand over the remote to Granny? Or would you be naughty and hide it? Nice or naughty? What will you decide? Nice or naughty, naughty or nice?
I like Sound of Music.
So you'd be nice?
Yeah.
Hold on to it. But will that be the right answer?
Huh?
Will that be the right answer?
Let's see.
Only the mystical crackers will tell us.
Okay.
Whoever gets the toy.
Okay, here we go. 1, 2, 3.
Oh!
I got it.
You were right to be nice. You were right to be nice. The mystical crackers have spoken. Okay, let's have another one, quick. Remember.
Okay.
Remember, you've still got gas in there.
Okay.
Remember, go
this one?
You go for gas! Yeah! Okay, here we go, you like this one, here we go. You sat with your family at Christmas dinner, you've eaten loads of stuff, and then suddenly... Or is it... Or is it... Do you be nice and admit it was you and say, it's me, sorry! And then waft it away, or do you be naughty? And blame it on Uncle Albert, who sat in the car.
I would blame it on Uncle
so
Albert.
So you'd be naughty! What? Is that right?
Let's see.
The mystical crackers. Here we go. Oh, no! The mystical crackers have spoken. It says you have to be nice.
Ew!
You have to blame it on
yourself. Whatever.
I've got time for one more.
Okay. What can we do? Chocs.
Are you sure about chocolates?
Yeah.
Okay, do you want to change your mind? Are you happy with the mind you got?
I like it.
Okay. Someone gives you a big box of chocolates on Christmas Eve. Would you be nice and save them to share them with the family on Christmas Day? Or would you be naughty and scoff them?
What do you think?
I reckon you'd be naughty.
Naughty, so hello.
Yeah. But is that the right? Will the mystical crackers
Let's
tell
us? Let's see. Let's see here.
Oh! No, you should have been nice.
Ew.
You greedy pig. You should have been nice, you see?
Oh, that's cute. Let me see.
It's you. So really... So really, what have we got there? We've got two nices and one naughty. And Brittany the crackers have said to me to tell you that you have to be nice at Christmas. So what I want you to do is take them with your family. If ever there's a dilemma, you know, for example, if they're, you know, you get a rubbish present bought or you don't know what to do, put them in the drawer, nip off to the drawer and open a mystical cracker.
Okay, I will do that. Thank you.
It's $49.
Thank you.
It's not a joke.
Huh?
It's $49. Okay. Brittany, you've got your first film coming out next year.
Mm-hmm.
Tell me a bit about it.
Well, the name of that movie is called Crossroads. And, you know, It's just a really heartfelt movie. It's really cool because I'm really passionate about it because I at the time before I did the movie, I had a lot of scripts that I was going to do, but I wanted something that, because it is a lot of hard work, I wanted to do something that I could put my heart all over. So I came up with the whole concept for the movie, and I got a writer to come in and to elaborate on it. It's a teen movie, but it also, and it's very funny, but it's a serious movie, and it's really heartfelt. And like, after you watch it, you're like,
I want to call my girlfriend.
You know, it's like one of those movies that you just really feel.
Well, I want to call your girlfriend.
Oh, you want to?
Okay. I'll call your girlfriend if you want. I mean, I'm...
Okay, you know. Okay.
If the film career goes well, which I'm sure it will do, you're going to ditch the singing?
Ditch the singing?
Get rid of it. Oh, you've got it. I mean, if the film's going well, you want to be on a nice film set, back in your trailer, do your scene, and
Honestly, the lifestyle is totally different, and it's more laid back, but the stage, I'm the happiest right now because I'm on stage, and I'm performing, I'm a performer, so this is my heart and soul, what I'm doing right now.
Because there's a girl in England, Charlotte Church, I'm hoping she gets a movie, so she ditches the singing, because between me and you, it ain't that hot. Now, Austin Powers, is there any truth in the rumour that you're going to be in his new film?
I can't say.
Okay. I actually met him in Cannes. He didn't mention anything, you know.
He didn't?
No. Are you going to be in it?
Huh? I can't say.
Okay, I'll tell you what. Put the camera on me. Just give me a... I won't say a thing. Like, so you can't see Brittany.
I won't say it. What?
Just either yes for... yes or... for no. Okay, that's between me and Brittany. I'm not saying anything. And I can't believe you told me. I'm so excited about it. I'm dead chill that she told me, and hey, you never know. I know, people will be coming up to me going, what is she doing? Is she doing it? I'll be like that. Well, my lips
are sealed.
Now, before I go, I've got to mention your personal life. Mm-hmm. The big question is, obviously, you're still going out with the guy from NSYNC.
Mm-hmm.
Been going out for a while now, haven't you?
Mm-hmm.
That's him there, isn't it?
Yeah, that's him.
Good looking lad.
Yeah,
he's... How long have you been seeing him now, if you don't mind asking? Well, come on, I've been doing...
I've been seeing him for like 3 years.
3 years?
Yeah.
But would you still go out with him if... Hold on a minute. He had a black tooth. Come on, truthfully.
I would.
Right, okay.
Because he kisses really good.
He what? He what?
Because he kisses really good.
Okay. You kiss good. What happens, right, Brittany?
Yeah.
Right, you ready? If he had those evil eyes.
I'd tell him to get contacts.
Right, okay. Okay. So you've told him you've got contacts. Say he comes back, right? Say he comes back, says, Brittany, I haven't got any contacts, but I did get two pairs of these glasses done in an hour.
I think those are cool.
Say they were bigger, Brittany. Say they were bigger glasses that only nerds wear.
Oh.
Yes or no?
I think I would.
Okay. What happens if he came back? What happens if he came back? He'd been to Germany and got himself one of those lovely German handlebar moustaches.
I like that. I think that's sexy.
What happens if he went away? And came back, he joined the Navy, and got one of those Navy earrings.
I like earrings.
What happens if he came back, and it was 666?
I wouldn't like
that. Thank you very much indeed. We got there eventually, didn't we?
Yeah. I wouldn't like that. That's bad. You're funny.